field advantage out of our fan base, as they've done all year for us. Should be an exciting game. I know it's an early kickoff, but really should be an exciting game for us. And, you know, I think the last time that we played A&M was in the Snow Bowl game. So I think, you know, kind of kicks that all back up again from that game. I think they're honoring that team at halftime during the game at some point. So should be pretty exciting for us. And real tough challenge, very talented football team. You know, obviously they got the best offense in the SEC, yards and points, and they put up huge numbers offensively, big stats with a lot of different playmakers on the field and tremendous skill at every position. And then they, you know, what gets overlooked a lot, I think, because of their offense is their defense. They have a stout defense. You know, and you look at the performance their defense has made, has been pretty impressive throughout the season.
So. You got a question, raise your hand, we'll get your microphone.
Hey, you guys are obviously very familiar with Kevin Sumlin, maybe more familiar than any other SEC staff because of playing them in the past. But how has his offense changed since you first faced his Houston team back in that 09?
Well, you know, I don't think his offense has changed much. The philosophy of his offense certainly hasn't changed. You know, I think he's done a good job tweaking it around the players. You know, third time I think we played against him, and the third different quarterback had to play, and that's offensively where you always start. You build around the strengths of your quarterbacks. They obviously do that now, building around the strength of their quarterback and his playmaking ability.
Then, I don't know, how much did you learn about your team in the Alabama game, and do you expect to really for this team to define itself over the next 4 weeks?
Oh, you always define yourself in November. To me, as a team of you know, what you're going to do, how you're going to perform to close out the season, and you know, we've put ourselves in position in a great position entering the month of December. I'm sorry, in the month of November right now. And, you know, and now this is where you have to see, this is what separates, you know, a good season from a great season, and a great season from a championship season, how you perform in the month of November.
Dan, how are those special teams mistakes against Alabama correctable, or are you what you are now on that side of the ball in November?
Well, no, I mean, everything's, you're constantly teaching. You either get better or you're getting worse every single day. So we're constantly working on every one of those techniques, individual responsibilities, and you know, I mean, it's just like on anything. There's a lot of different things. There's 11 guys that have to execute perfectly every play. Is what you need, and if you have a breakdown, a lot of times it'll be glaring, especially against very good football teams.
As you get past the Alabama loss, is this one of those games? How do you approach it? Do you really dissect the film and hammer home all the mistakes, or do you just kind of say Alabama was that good and let's move on?
We do what we do every week, which is, you know, look at where we made mistakes, how we could have done better. You know, I mean, how, you know, every week we look at how we won, how we lost the game. We haven't lost very often and recently, but you know, how, what were the determining factors, and so that we can point and correct on all of those issues. So. You know, we watched the film this morning with the guys, and you know, at team meeting, we watched, go through and review all the things that we did positively, all the things we did negatively, and hopefully grow on the positives and correct the negatives. And, very much as we've done for every other game so far this season.
Because you've always had a good success of junior college players coming in here, and obviously it takes them a while to develop. It seems like the Nico started.
Yeah, you know, I mean, one thing, you know, we recruit junior college players to come in and make an impact for the most part, you know, because they have shorter careers than high school guys, and less time to develop within your program. So, you know, we try to make emphasis on recruiting guys that are going to come in and be able to step on the field right away and make an impact. And, I think the transition, though, from junior college to the Southeastern Conference is a step, and I think there is an adjustment period for guys. And I think, you know, a lot of those guys, you'll see some flashes on a play here and there early, but as they continue to play more and more and get accustomed in the system, you see more consistent play out of them. And, you know, Nico's one of those guys. I think he's adapting to becoming that consistent player that